Spirit of thy will be king. St. James the Greater, pray for us. St. Christina, pray for us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Well, boys, already it's the time for the last day of your summer camp, and I hope that you all have an excellent day, and that as you get ready to leave this afternoon, you make some good resolutions. You have a few ideas that you'll keep in your heart, and you'll recommend them to Our Lady for her graces, so that the time that you spent here hasn't just been, well, some fun and some diversion during the summer, but I mean a way to get closer to God, to help you to get closer to your goal, which is to go to heaven one day. Last night we spoke a little bit about the devil, some of the things that the devil does. Remember that there are two ways of getting rid of the devil, just two, our Lord says. He says you can't cast the devil out except by prayer and by penance. Father wore purple vestments for his mass this morning. Purple always stands for penance. It stands in the church as well for a preparation. For example, purple during Lent, preparation for Easter. But preparation always means some prayer and some penance. And one of the best ways to do penance is always to do it with our Blessed Mother. As we shall see today, we're preparing, doing a little penance to get ready for the feast of a great saint of Mary tomorrow, and the patron saint of the Crusaders, Saint James the Greater, one of the greatest saints and one of the greatest apostles. How would you do penance? Oh, for example, if you didn't feel like getting up in the morning, you would get up anyway. If you felt like making some kind of a smart comment, you wouldn't. Sometimes you'd let someone else go in front of you. You might not take second someday. If you don't feel like saying your prayers, remember we spoke about the act of contrition always before you go to bed, you would say them anyway. You might feel like being in church, you might feel like slouching, especially if you see other people slouch, then you kneel up straight instead. You might say an extra decade here or an extra Hail Mary there. That's a great act of penance. And all the penance, boys, we offer up to God to the hands of our Blessed Mother. Then it becomes very, very powerful. Now today, we keep the feast day of a saint in her own right. She is a girl who could put a lot of you boys to shame when it comes to bravery, courage, fortitude. She was a true soldier of Christ. Her name is Christina. When she was 10, she was converted directly by the Holy Ghost. As some people are still today. It's not always through hearing others or seeing others. Sometimes it's almost a direct grace from God. Well, she got talking to her father and explaining to her father that she couldn't worship the false gods that he had in their house anymore. They were idols made out of silver and gold, and each one, of course, is a devil. And she explained she could only worship the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. And he said, well, that's three gods right there. Why not just worship a few more? And she said, oh, no, Father. There's only one God, but three divine persons. She explained to him a bit about the Trinity, but he didn't understand. Later on, she broke up all of the idols, and she gave the gold and the silver pieces to the poor. Her father was so angry at that he himself had her arrested, and he supervised her being tortured. And at some point, she was so brave and so plucky that as they were tearing at her skin with iron hooks, she picked up a piece of her own flesh, and she tossed it at her dad and said, here, Father, here is the flesh of the child whom you have begotten. Are you not ashamed to do this? What a brave girl she was. Did quite a few miracles at her torture and martyrdom, and finally she was killed by arrow. Christina, the name reminds us of Christ, the anointed one. Remember, boys, don't let girls outdo you. You have been anointed twice now, once at holy baptism, and most of you have been confirmed, too. Confirmed, strengthened by the Holy Ghost, soldiers of Christ. You have to be brave. Do you remember the storm? Were you here for the storm on Monday night? And it kept some of us awake because there was a tremendous amount of thunder and wind and lightning. When you think of a storm like that, you could think of a saint whose feast is tomorrow, whose vigil is today, Saint James the Greater. Our Lord gave, the Lord liked to give nicknames, new names and nicknames. We gave him and his brother, Saint John the Evangelist, the nicknames of the Sons of Thunder, because once they wanted God to send thunder or fire down from heaven to destroy a certain city in Samaria which refused to believe in our Lord. But our Lord said, no, no, you don't know what spirit you are. That's not my way. Because now was their time for grace. And now was the time for God to be patient with them. Later on, they would be punished if that were necessary. But he always had that great zeal, boys. He was always just on fire for doing something great for God. In the word, he was energetic and he was very brave, which meant he was self-disciplined. He wasn't lazy or self-centered or soft. In other words, he was a true man. He was a true man of God. He was one of our Lord's three favorite disciples. They were the ones who were allowed to see him raise this little girl, the daughter of Jairus, from the dead. They saw him transfigured with glory on Mount Tabor, the way our Lord would be on after his resurrection. And they saw him in his agony in the garden. Well, St. John, St. James, one of the Sons of Thunder, was also a favorite of our Blessed Mother because he loved her and prayed to her, and she saw how brave he was and how much he loved her son and wanted to spread his kingdom. Only our Blessed Mother realized that she had 12 boys in her family, the 12 apostles, and she didn't want to make any of the others jealous. So what she did usually is she just appeared secretly to St. James the Greater, and the other apostles, not even St. John, always knew about these apparitions, but she gave him a lot of strength and a lot of encouragement. Because he went to Spain, and he spent almost 5 years in Spain preaching the gospel, making converts, and he left bishops behind him to organize the church. Then he went back to the Holy Land, and in the year 41 A.D., he preached for the last time. And there was a certain witch or magician. Back then, the magicians had great powers from the devil. They did extraordinary things. This man's name is Hermogenes. And the Pharisees went to see him, and they said, we need you to get rid of that apostle, St. James. He's doing us a lot of damage. So Hermogenes said, no sooner said than done, I'll do it. And what he did finally was to send demons from hell to kill St. James. When they arrived, though, of all things, these devils were begging St. James to release them because they said, the angels are punishing us before our time. In other words, at the end of the world, all of the devils will go down into hell and their punishment will be very severe for all eternity. But right now, when they're flying around and making mischief, their punishment isn't quite so severe, even though they are still in hell. Well, St. James said to the demon, I will release you from your suffering now if you bring me that man, Hermogenes, and I want you to tie him up with chains. The devil said, they tied up the witch or the magician with chains, and they delivered him to St. James, and Hermogenes stood before him all covered with confusion. He had no more powers, and he said, here I am, I'm in your power, do whatever you want to me. And St. James said, the Christian thing to do is to forgive, and I forgive you. So here he told the demons, take his chains off, let him go free. And Hermogenes said, oh no, I'm afraid as soon as I leave, the demons will get their revenge on me, because that's how they are, I know. Give me something of yours. Give me one of your relics to protect you, me. So he gave, St. James said, he gave this man, who had just been a sorcerer or a witch, his staff, his walking stick. And he said, now with this, you'll be protected. Well, right away, he was converted by the kindness and the goodness of this apostle. And he said, I'm going to burn all of my bad books. If you come across a bad book, it's an excellent thing, boys, to burn it. But if it is a book which has incantations in it, or invocations to the devil, one has to be very careful even with that, because sometimes the smoke can cause damage. So St. James said, don't burn the book, throw them into the sea. So he walked with the staff, and he threw them all into the ocean. And then he came back to St. James, and he was his disciple from then on. The Jews were so furious at that, and about him preaching about our Lord's passion and resurrection, that they tied a rope around his neck, and they dragged him to Herod Agrippa, who was the puppet king of the Romans at that time in the Holy Land. And Herod Agrippa put him to death as a way of making the Jews happy. So he was the first apostle to die for our holy faith. But in the meantime, he had shown his great love for Jesus and his for Mary, and a wonderful spirit of making converts. Well, his body was taken to Spain by two disciples in a boat, and it was buried in a certain place called Galicia in northwestern Spain. There, it lay unknown for centuries. Till finally one day, did you see the stars last night, boys, at the campfire? There were all of these stars, far more than you'd even see in a place far away from a city. And all of the stars seemed to point to one place, and they went there, and the Christians found the tomb of St. James. And they built a great church there, and people came from all over the world on foot. They still do today, on foot, to honor this great apostle of Jesus and of Mary, St. James the Greater, called the Field of Stars, Compostela. Well, at that time, the Muslims had invaded most of Spain, which is a peninsula called the Iberian Peninsula. So they conquered Africa, and then they went right up into Spain, and the Christians had a very hard time, the Crusaders did, to drive them out. At one point, and this happens sometimes in history, there was only a small group of good Catholic Crusaders left, and they'd been having a hard time fighting with the Muslims, and they were discouraged. The devil always uses discouragement, boys. He wants to get us to give up, get tired, and say, oh, why should I even bother? I guess I'll just go along with everybody else. That's what the devil's waiting for. Never let him do that to you. And if you pray to Our Lady, she'll send a saint or an angel to help you. So this is what happened. There were just a few Spanish crusaders left. They were defending a crucial kind of a pass because they needed to stop the advance of the Moors or the Muslims and beat them back, get them out of their country, out of Spain. And all of a sudden, who appears to take the leadership of their troops? St. James himself appears. He's on a horse, and he holds a banner, a white with a red cross upon it, and he has a sword. And St. James led the attack, and he himself slew so many Muslims that the hoofs of his horse were dyed red in the blood of the Moors. They say he killed 70,000 in one battle, if you can imagine it. That's why the Spanish and the Mexicans have a very great veneration for St. James. They call him Señor Santiago Apostol, the Lord St. James, the Apostle. And then they call him the Matamoros, the Moor Slayer, because he slew all of the Muslims. That's the true Christian spirit, boy, to fight against those who deny our Lord's divinity and who want to take away the true Catholic faith from us and send us all to hell to boot. St. James is the patron saint of crusaders. And I leave him with you today, boys, to be your patron saint. He's someone who fought against the devil. He is someone who is full of zeal and enthusiasm. He was not soft. He was not a sissy. He was a real man, a real man of God. He conquered himself so he could conquer others. He loved Our Lady very much. And whenever he would grow a little discouraged, Our Lady would come to him to encourage him. I hope that you will take our Blessed Mother home with you from these three wonderful days of camp, boys, and that you will remember the wonderful lessons of all of the saints, but especially the patron saints and crusaders, St. James. God bless you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.